There is a pain that welled up inside her body as the child left it. And then the pain stayed. There was a gnashing and tearing at her inside that seemed determined to reduce her to shreds of flesh. Every time she tried to stand up, her legs gave way, as though without bones. Her body, splayed to the ground in a mess of limbs and groans and twisted mayhem. The wails of her child matched her own. Both were muted, silent. Hers trapped behind a face distorted by pain and anguish. A tear dropped for no one to see. Then a deep guttural groan was drawn out of her throat for no one to hear. Eyes wide with sorrow and fear, wisps locks of wet hair snaking down the strained muscles of her face. Time passed in this torment. And then the pain started to subside. But only because it was overpowered by pangs of hunger in her stomach and a dryness in her throat. She knew she had to go. One by one, she set the soles of her feet on the ground. She sat on them, and then she straightened her body. She walked. Into the endless expanse of the desert, she walked, she stumbled, she fell. All round her, everything was repetition. A cloudless sky spread over her head without alteration. She walked, she stumbled, she fell. All round her was a haze of dirty brown rock, a light blue sky. All round her was repetition, except for the cyclope's eye of the sun glaring at her with merciless heat. She walked, she stumbled, she fell. Whose roots suckled from the water stream beneath. She looked round. All was a haze of dirty brown rock and light blue sky. There was no tree. The voice descended again. It bequeathed her to go to the stream, wash her face, quench her thirst. Nothing was around her.
Ah! Would that I had died before this! Would that I had been a thing forgotten!
Moment of greatest weakness. She felt a wetness beneath her feet. It seeped through the cracked earth. It gurgled and bubbled and purred into a water stream, clear and blue, snaking and rippling and whispering and weaving its way across the earth and disappearing into the rock mountains as if it had always been there. And over her, the regal leaves of the palm tree dangled the ripe fruit through their delicate fingers. She shook the bark of the tree, but only a little before the ripe fruit dropped, bounced, and settled at her feet in rhythmic percussion. She washed her face and clenched her thirst. She bit into the sweet fruit and nursed her baby under the shade. With this renewed strength and regained faith, She held her fatherless baby to her bosom and walked to her people, knowing fully well the slander, the insults, the humiliation she was about to endure for this child. But just as the tree sucked life from the water stream beneath, so she drew her strength from above.